It's a very great day. Hope you are enjoying all the videos so far. What a nice time meeting with wonderful, brilliant, intelligent, and inquisitive students like you. Now let us go on immediately. Quantitative analysis continues for external exams. Now look at it. If you want to confirm carbon 4 oxide, what you use to confirm it is lime water. Look at the test, look at the observation, look at the inference. There are two major tests, that is why you need to watch the other videos. Now, when you add ACl to any compound that contains CO3, or CO2 as the case may be, you are going to have effervescence, and you begin to suggest, you begin to think that what will be liberated from that will be CO2. Now, if you don't add ACl, you could as well decide to heat it. You can apply heat. So when you apply heat, there will also be effervescence of the colorless gas. It turns blue litmus paper red, and it extinguishes glowing or burning splint, and turns lime water milky. With all these characteristics, you know and you are sure that the gas that is evolved is CO2. Now, from the observation, what could S be? This is a rhetorical question, and you need to calm down and watch it again to have full understanding. S could be Ca, CO3, or Na, CO3. S can never be Na2CO3. Why? Because the triazocarbonate 4 of group 1 elements are not decomposed by it. When you apply heat on the triazocarbonate 4 of group 1 element, they melt. They don't break down. They don't decompose. So that's the more reason that it's either CaCO3 or NaCO3, because these two can be decomposed by heat. Let's move on to the next slide. Now look at it. When you have another test, observation and inference, when you have Na2SO3 plus dilute HCl, you have an effervescence of the gas. But look at the compound that is given to you, Na2CO3. So from this compound, you should start thinking that the gas that will come out will be CO2. And that CO2 is from a radical, which is SO3 2-. So there will be an effervescence of the gas. The gas has irritating smell. The gas turned blue litmus paper red. Now look at the further test. When you now decide to use filter paper, and you soak that filter paper in acidified KMnO4, or you decide to use filter paper that is soaked in acidified K2CR207, the gas will turn purple color of KMnO4 colorless. It will turn it colorless. Now, K2CR207 is orange or yellow in color. The color will be turned green without any precipitate. So when you have this, when you see this, SO2 gas is confirmed. Yes, obviously, SO2 gas is confirmed. So please, you have to learn it again. Learn it more and more and more. The more you press, the more you understand. The more you watch, the more you listen. Write down. Now press the comment button, send your questions to me. I'll be delighted to attend to them. Have a wonderful day.